need to get my injection done.
First one. Are you nervous?
Yeah. My IVF medications have arrived, and it's time to start my first injection.
I need one of these and one of these, right? Mm-hmm. I need this. Do we need one of these?
Yep. In order to create a whole lot of eggs for the egg retrieval process, I have to pump my body full of hormones, which means, like, I'm gonna be emotional, bloated, tired, and I can't have any coffee to help with the caffeine headaches.
Is it gonna,
watch
like,
out, I don't know.
Yeah, I was just saying, mood changes? It's gonna be a rough road for me.
Yeah. Oh. I feel really bad for you.
Yeah, I know. I have these to go next, through all this
these next few months are gonna be really hard for you.
What do you mean, did it wrong? This, like, super expensive. Don't screw this up.
Even though we're taught how to do these injections at the doctor's office, it's a little overwhelming. And there's lots of bottles that need to be mixed, and everything is an exact science.
It's very, like, precise and, like, tedious.
Any little hiccup can mess up the whole process, and I might not have enough eggs for the egg retrieval, which would mean that we don't have enough embryos to be genetically tested. It's a big deal.
Our journey to grow our family has had a lot of heartache. We've pretty much sunk a majority of our life savings into this process to get a child to bring home.
Right, so we're gonna do it two finger lengths away?
Mm-hmm. Don't forget you have to insert it at a 90 degree angle. They were very clear on that.
Get rid of the bubble.
No, not. They have to do 90 degrees.
It's like nerve-wracking.
Okay. Nate, oh my God.
Stop.
You're going way too fast. He looks super nervous, and the only thing going through my head is I have to make sure it's done correctly. No.
You sure you can do it? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, you just stepped or something. Did that hurt?
I don't know how she can inject herself with a needle, because I'd be like, I don't know if I could do it.
I'm just mentally tough.
Yeah, I know. Not so much here.
That's it.
Now that the first shot is done, I have to do one every night until the egg retrieval, which is about a week away. I'm just hoping that my body reacts correctly, that I'm producing enough eggs, that I have a schedule down, that I don't forget anything. It's just a lot. I did it.
One down.
A lot more shots to go.
How done are you with these two other guys?
So today's my egg retrieval, and hopefully I did all the shots correctly, because if I didn't get everything done correctly, I might not have enough eggs for the egg retrieval. I don't think people realize that, you know, the egg retrieval is an actual surgery. I'm gonna have to go under anesthesia. It's pretty invasive.
Lauren, mm-hmm. Hi. My name's Morgan. I'm gonna be the nurse getting you ready today. Hi.
As Lauren's about to go into this procedure, I know we've done as much as we can, and now it's just out of our hands.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good.
Ready for this?
Yeah.
So, the main thing that we're gonna do today is slide a needle through the vaginal wall into the ovary and suck every drop of fluid out of each of the follicles that's there. Within the fluid, that's where the eggs are. With the IVF process, my lab is going to combine the sperm and the egg together, which makes an embryo. We will then let the embryos develop in the lab, and the ones that make it to the point where we can test them, we'll do that.
All right, I'll take good care of her.
Thank you.
When I wake up from the egg retrieval, Dr. Larson is gonna tell me how many eggs he was able to retrieve. I just want the highest amount possible because I want all this time, money, work to be worth it that I can actually bring home a baby.
That's I gave you a little medicine to the intravenous already. You're gonna start to feel it in a moment or two.
Everybody ready? We're gonna go ahead and get started on the right side. As you can see, we can see her right ovary quite nicely. And I'm gonna advance the needle into the ovary and start aspirating the fluid now. The typical egg retrieval where we harvest the eggs, we only lose about an ounce of blood or so. However, I have one time in 17 years experienced a situation where her ovary would not stop bleeding after her egg retrieval. And unfortunately, we had to operate on her that night and remove the ovary.
When we first went in to get the egg retrieval, you know, they said it's probably gonna take about 30 minutes. And next thing I know, I look at the clock and I feel like it's been 45, 50 minutes. And so it's taking longer. Is she all right? Is everything going all right? It's kind of nerve-wracking as a husband, you know?
That's always a relief to hear him say first egg. What that tells me is that she gave herself the trigger shot correctly. If it had been administered incorrectly, we would have gotten absolutely no eggs today. All right, so that does it for the right side. Time to switch over to the left. Left ovary, I was expecting it to be a little bit easier. Getting a really good look at this left ovary. I'm gonna go ahead and take the needle out. Looks like we're good. All right, all done. My worst case scenario is having her go through all of this and end up at the end of the day with no embryos that we can use. We're in recovery, all done.
Lauren, how are you feeling? Good. A little sleepy?
Nate, we are all done. Come on back with me. Yeah, she's doing great. She did not have any difficulties at all with anesthesia.
It's hard seeing Lauren sitting in the recovery room because it brought back memories of Ray and Ruby. I feel like, you know, in the past, you know, we've always got bad news. I am afraid to find out how many eggs we got because to have this process not work, it would crush Lauren because she knows we can't afford it after that and to not get pregnant out of that, and what do we do? You know, then we have to explore other options, but we don't have that many more options.
Honestly, I was hoping for 12. I was a little bit worried that we might not get quite as many. Total number of eggs, we got 16.
Okay.
16's a great start, but it is just that, it's a start. You know, we've got a long ways to go, and part of that starts today with the fertilization of the eggs.
I'm really relieved that the egg retrieval went well, but we still have the next hurdle to jump over, which is to find out, you know, how many of those eggs become embryos.
Just hoping and praying that there is a good result in the end.